Hey there, geologists! Bee here from the Miaverse. My investigation today brings me to the Mississippi River Delta in Louisiana, here at the intersection of coastal ecosystems, human developments, and the Gulf of Mexico. A variety of influences are at play, shaping the land in astonishing ways. The net result? The Mississippi Delta and coastal Louisiana are rapidly disappearing into the ocean. About a football field of wetlands is lost every 100 minutes, with thousands of square miles lost since the 1930s. So, what's going on? Why is the coastline here disappearing? Today, we'll be investigating all of this and more as we explore the processes of erosion and deposition. Ready, geologists? Let's get to digging! Our journey begins far from the ocean at the mighty Mississippi River. In our last expedition, we explored how rivers contribute to weathering, where flowing water and the sediment it carries grind away at the rocks in its path. But weathering is just the beginning. What happens to the rocks after they've been broken down? This is where erosion comes into play. Erosion is the removal of rocks, sediment, or soil from a location. It's like nature's cleanup crew. While weathering breaks the rocks apart, erosion sweeps them away. Or think of it as nature's delivery service. When rocks erode, they're picked up and carried away to new destinations. Nature uses a variety of mechanisms to accomplish this. Looking behind me, can you guess what one of the mechanisms of erosion is? That's right, water. Here, the river's current carries sediment along, sometimes over great distances. Rainwater runoff also contributes, as does the movement of ocean currents. But water isn't the only delivery method nature uses. What other forces might cause erosion? Pause here and record your ideas in your notes. Wind is another powerful force of erosion. In deserts, wind sweeps up small particles like sand and dust, creating features like sand dunes. In icy landscapes, glaciers act as colossal movers, slowly carving valleys and shaping mountains. And then there's gravity. It pulls rocks downhill, causing landslides and rockfalls in steep areas. As we can see, nature has a variety of mechanisms that cause erosion, but these rock fragments don't travel forever. Just like a delivery service eventually drops a package off at a final destination, nature has to drop the rocks off somewhere. Take the Mississippi River, for instance. Looking at this map of the river, take a moment to predict where these loose bits of rock might be headed. If you guessed the Gulf of Mexico, you're spot on. Let's head to the Gulf now and explore this process further. Welcome to the Gulf of Mexico, where the Mississippi River's journey comes to an end. This sprawling landscape is a masterpiece of deposition. Deposition is the process by which sediments, soil, and rocks are added to a landform or landmass, just like making a deposit in a bank. But instead of money, nature is depositing bits of rock and soil from one place to another. In this case, the river is carrying sediment from as far north as Minnesota. It picks up soil, sand, and organic material and deposits them here, creating a complex network of wetlands, marshes, and channels. These areas where rivers meet oceans are called deltas. A delta is a landform at the mouth of a river that is created by deposition. As the river's flow slows near the ocean, the sediment it carries is deposited, building up new land. Deltas can be found around the world and are known for their rich, fertile soil. This is because they receive a continuous supply of fresh nutrients, such as minerals and organic matter, from upstream. When deposited, they create layers of nutrient-rich soil, which is perfect for supporting lush vegetation and diverse ecosystems. But deltas like the Mississippi River Delta here are just one way that deposition creates new landforms. Let's think back to our earlier mechanisms of erosion, such as wind and ocean waves. When sediment from these processes is picked up and deposited somewhere else, what landscapes might be created as a result? Pause and record your thoughts in your notes. In deserts and coastal areas, wind plays a key role in deposition, forming sand dunes as it carries and deposits loose sand particles. Beaches are another example where waves deposit sand, pebbles, and shells along the shore. These landforms, deltas, dunes, and beaches, demonstrate the power of deposition in shaping the Earth's surface, showcasing how natural forces work together to create and transform landscapes. However, like weathering, erosion and deposition don't just happen on their own. They are influenced by various factors. Geologists, what do you think could affect erosion and deposition here at the Mississippi Delta? Pause and record your thoughts in your notes. One major factor is weather patterns, especially the intensity of rainfall. Here in Louisiana, heavy rain swells the Mississippi River, increasing its flow and carrying more sediment downstream. This leads to significant erosion upstream and greater deposition in the delta. Storms, particularly hurricanes like Camille and Katrina, have an even more dramatic impact. Powerful winds and waves can cause extensive erosion along the coastline and within the delta, reshaping the land in a short time. But it's not just the weather that plays a role. Living organisms also influence erosion and deposition. In the delta, plant roots stabilize the soil, reducing erosion by anchoring it in place. Microorganisms like bacteria break down organic matter, creating more stable soil structures. And animals like beavers build natural dams that slow water flow, decreasing erosion and promoting sediment deposition. Meanwhile, grazing animals eat plants, exposing the soil to erosion, and burrowing animals loosen soil stabilized by microorganisms, making it more susceptible to being washed away. All these factors, whether they increase or decrease erosion and deposition, aren't inherently good or bad. It's all about balance. However, in the Mississippi River Delta, large amounts of land are lost every year. So what's disrupting this balance? Unfortunately, this balance has been significantly disrupted by human activities. Levees and dams, while essential for flood control, have altered the natural flow of the Mississippi River, preventing sediment from being deposited in wetlands where it would normally build up the land. Instead, much of this sediment is lost to the deeper waters of the Gulf of Mexico. Deforestation and agriculture also contribute to this problem. Wetlands have been drained for infrastructure and farmland, reducing the delta's ability to absorb floodwaters and prevent erosion. Without the stabilizing effect of vegetation, the delta becomes more vulnerable to erosion and biodiversity loss. Climate change, which is also influenced by human activity, amplifies these issues. Rising sea levels and more frequent intense storms like Hurricanes Camille and Katrina increase erosion and disrupt the Delta's fragile ecosystems. Saltwater intrusion from rising seas further damages freshwater plants and habitats, accelerating the Delta's decline. But humans can also have a positive impact. Louisiana has recognized the need to protect and restore the Delta. The state's coastal master plan includes projects to restore wetlands, replant vegetation, and create new land through sediment deposition. This plan integrates scientific research, engineering, and community input to develop sustainable strategies for the Delta's future. All right, geologists, let's recap what we covered today. Erosion happens when bits of rock and sediment are carried away from one place, while deposition is when they settle down somewhere new. These processes work together to shape and reshape our landscapes, continuously breaking down old landforms and building up new ones. This never-ending cycle is driven by factors like weather and the activities of living organisms, showing just how dynamic and interconnected our planet truly is. In our next lesson, we'll take a look at one of nature's most valuable resources, soil. Until then, remember, this whole planet is one giant sculpture, and we all have a chisel, so don't underestimate the impact you can have. Stay observant, keep asking questions, and I'll see you next time. Hey, hey.